This video was brought to you by the ILC. Hello there once again, welcome to episode 16. In this episode, I'm going to show you how to write your own piecewise function based on a word problem. Let's give it a try. A country's tax code taxes any earnings less than or equal to $20,000 at a 10% rate, and taxes any earnings above $20,000 at a 20% rate. Write a piecewise function to find the tax. Before we do anything else, we'll need to define our variables. The problem says that we are supposed to write a function to find tax, which means tax is the dependent variable, and so tax should be our y. Now we have to ask ourselves, what does tax depend on? Well, tax is going to depend on what you earn, your earnings. So that means the independent variable should be your earnings. All right, with that in mind, our first step in trying to write a piecewise function is to find the changeover point. Because once we know what the changeover point is, we can start breaking it into pieces and then figure out what each piece is. Well, the first part of the problem says that the tax, if you are less than or equal to 20,000, is a certain percentage. And then if you're above 20,000, it's a different percentage. So the percentage changes at $20,000, which is an x value, because that 20,000 is our earnings. If we are going to start writing a piecewise function, have to say y equals, and then put the braces on, and then we'll just go ahead and write our conditions first. Well, our first condition is less than or equal to 20,000. And since it's not possible to have negative money, we'll actually start with 0. We'll say 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to $20,000. And then that'll be piece A. For the other piece, we have any x's that are above $20,000. So we'll write x greater than 20,000. Call that piece B. Now that we know the changeover, our second step is going to be to find the first equation for piece A. Well, let's start from the general form. Y equals m x minus x1 plus y1. All right, so it says that for A, in between 0 and 20,000, we have a 10% rate. So our m is 0.1. Now we don't have an x1 or a y1 mentioned in this problem, because they don't say anything about an initial value, so both of them will be 0. We'll have x minus 0 plus 0, or in simpler form, y equals 0.1x. We'll go ahead and put that right here in our piecewise function. Now that we know what the line is, our next task will be to find the value at the changeover point. Once we have the value at the changeover point, we'll be able to write the second equation a lot easier. Well, we know that the changeover is x equals 20,000. So let's take this equation we just wrote and try to find its value when x equals 20,000. Well, we have 0.1 times x, or 0.1 times 20,000, which is 2,000. Which means our value at the changeover is 20,000 for x, comma, 2,000. That'll be our coordinate, and that's going to help us write the second equation. That will be our fourth step to find the equation for piece B. Once again, we'll start from our general form. Y equals m, x minus x1, plus y1. But our M for this one is going to be a different percentage. It says in the question that our new M, when we're above 20,000, is 20%. Or 0.20 in decimal form. Our X1 will be the X value at the changeover. I'll label it over here. It'll be 20,000. And our Y1 in this equation will be the Y of the changeover, and it'll be 2,000. So our equation becomes Y equals 0.20 times X minus 20,000 plus 2,000. Just for good measure, I'll write it again over here in the piece. Alright, and so that is our piecewise function. Our piecewise function is now complete. Let's go ahead and try to graph it. So here's our piecewise function again, and we know that the changeover is at 20,000. So the first thing we should do is draw a vertical line, label it as x equals 20,000. The part on the left is piece A, the part on the right is piece B. Now we have 0.10x as our piece A. That's going to start at the origin because it has no offset. And it's going to go until we reach the changeover. We'll just plot that right here. We'll draw a line connecting them, and then we'll stop right there. Now piece B is going to have a different slope. It's a higher number, so the line should turn a little bit and get steeper. And we'll just draw that going off to infinity. Again, not a perfect line. It's just a sketch. Doesn't have to be too accurate. All right. Well, that's all I have for piecewise functions. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again next episode.